Yeah. Hey, eat up. Slowing down. Is that all you've got? That's the forbidden burning tongue technique. And I'll do it too. Go, 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 go! Ow! Hot, hot! Oh, looks like it's a tie. Not many people can keep up with me. I'm impressed. That's so. Guess it was close then. Oh. Had a lot of gods challenging me at Takoyaki, though. I respect that. I knew you had potential when I met you. See it. Tie's no better than a loss. I'll do like I promised and run 100 laps around the city. You do whatever you think is best. Heck of a fight today. See you around.
Sutra with a hangover is gonna be rough. Back in the day, all I needed was a cold shower and I'd be fine no matter how much I drank. I guess I'm getting old, huh? It's always in times like these, when it's hardest to be alone. You asking if there are other monks at my temple? My temple's small. I don't depend on nobody but myself. I'm the only one there. If you think about it, it's better to be alone. Less stress. You don't have to wait for someone else to get out of the bathroom when you need to go. My son took forever in there. way to achieve peace and serenity. Everything we see has form. No form has permanence. It's all in constant motion. Form has no self. Its true face is that of emptiness. And yet, form is emptiness, and emptiness is form. No two things in this world are the same. Well, to put it simply, no matter how hard you try to live your life right, someone else can always mess it up. Because form is emptiness, and emptiness is form. Maybe getting involved with you messed up my life a bit too. I'm gonna go home, kid. My head's killing me. Oh yeah, about the memorial service. It was a seventh-day memorial. It was only 19. Random murder victim. What a harsh world we live in. Be careful on your way home too, kid.
How are you doing? I remembered a little more. The end won't be brought about by any one person in particular. It's going to happen because there are many who wish for it, almost as if it was decided from the beginning. But isn't it strange that there are those who would wish to bring about the end? I see. Well, I guess if you're unhappy, you'd want it to be over quickly, huh? Otherwise, you might end up consumed by hatred for everything in this world. Well, enough of that for now. There was one more thing I wanted to tell you today. Soon, the flowers of poison will bloom. Three in the rival garden, and one in your own. I don't know if this has anything to do with the end, but you should be careful. I just wanted you to know. I'm worried about you. I'll let you know if I find out anything else. That's what friends are for, right? Well then, good night.
Elizabeth speaking. I'm calling in regard to a recent change in Tartarus. It seems that a path that had been blocked off is now open. I thought it prudent to inform you. Well then, I wish you a safe journey.
It's me. I'm sorry to disturb you, but do you have a moment?
Good morning. There's actually something I need to tell everyone, but I think it would be best if you saw it for yourself. So I'd like for all of us to meet in the command room tonight. I'll see you then.
Hello? Once I had a melon pond, then a katsu sandwich. Then an agé pond, a kané pond, a yakisoba pond, apple strudel, another agé pond. But I gotta have my rice, too. I think that might have been too many carbs. Today, a girl in my class asked me, "Who's that cute guy you went to Umiyoshi with?" She wanted me to introduce you two so you could eat lunch together. Without me. Girls always go for guys like you. Or my little brother. I guess looks really are everything. But once we're dead, we'll all just be bones. You can't tell a handsome skeleton from an ugly one. Not again! Why do my memories make me so damn hungry? Hey, waiter! Another tonkatsu special! While we wait for the food, let me share a little Senryu poem I wrote. He who cuts you is no friend, but he who cuts you, flavor until the end. Huh? Oh. Oh! My stomach! Emergency! Whew. That was way too close. If that toilet was just a bit further away, oh boy. No, I'm fine. No worries. Everything's good and normal over here. Except for my weight, that is. Ah! The Gourmet King shouldn't say things like that. I didn't mean to be so crass. I mean, who wants to talk about toilets while they're eating? I keep saying toilet! Sorry. Okay, enough of that. Let's shovel that food down. We have to eat every chance we get. Because once we're dead, all we'll be eating is dust. You know, just like my little brother.
Have we received a new mission?
I don't know, but the alarm's not ringing.
Collar is designed to help control his persona. Basically, it's an evoker for dogs.
Wait, does that mean Koromaru is going to fight with us?
I honestly wasn't expecting this either, but the test results show it's quite possible. In fact, it was actually a request from the chairman. We'll be looking after him here in the dorm.
Koro-chan, is this what you want? He says, I'm returning the favor.
Man, you're one loyal dog.
Hey, sounds good to me. I, for one, welcome him with open arms. The more the merrier, right? Who cares if you're a dog? All right, I'll take him for a walk. And it's the perfect time, because it's summer break.
Yes. It is. You're free to enjoy your vacation, but don't forget about your schoolwork. Summer classes start next week, so don't lose focus just because we have a lot of time off.
Wait, what'd you say?
Summer classes. Did you not hear about them? We're going to be taking supplemental courses. I've already applied for all of us. I know how difficult it's been to balance both school and our late-night excursions. I'm sure you haven't had much time to study, so I apologize for that. The chairman agreed it was a good idea as well. I could have sworn I told Takeba and Yamagishi.
You serious? First I've heard of it!
Oh, sorry. I completely forgot to mention it.
No way!
you're the one with the worst grades here. Why are you so surprised?
Come on! I don't want to hear it. This sucks. Don't you think?
Well, it's only for a few weeks, so let's do our best.
The other day, a woman came to my office asking for a donation. Quite the looker, I might add. In fact, she was very much my type. But no matter how attractive she was, I was repulsed by her dedication to charity work. Of course not. I hate the very word. Why should I have to give my hard-earned money to a bunch of freeloaders? I pulled myself up out of squalor to get where I am today. I wanted to get back at the ones who used to laugh at me. That's what I always dreamed of, anyway. But, to tell you the truth, now I have too much money. Profits are booming. I'm so busy, I don't have time to spend a yen of it. Maybe I should train someone to take my place. I could teach them my business philosophy and management techniques. It'd be a carbon copy of me. It would probably cost me a fortune, but if it works, then it's easy living. How would you feel about being adopted? Only joking. People would get funny ideas if I took in a child as old as you. For the sake of the less fortunate, huh? I'm going to do it! Good, good. Not bad, kid. Thanks, kid. Bye-bye.
One magnificent melon, ain't she? It's the highlight of my day. So, I've been thinking of throwing a watermelon splitting party. We haven't really done anything summery since vacation started, you know? Especially Amada. He always looks so bored when I see him in the morning. And man, that kills me to see. It'd be a real shame if he didn't have a single entry in his summer picture diary. Already see the look on his face. He'll be like, Jupe-san, you're super cool and you're super nice. Oh, I mean, don't you know? They say women can't resist a guy with a soft spot for kids. And you know what that means? I'm gonna need your help. It's a win-win situation, don't you think? Anywho, oh boy. I think my arms are gonna fall off. Ah, yes. Today's shaping up to be a glorious day. Such a shame that the third years and the ladies won't be joining us.
If we're splitting watermelons, I'm out.
What? Just like that? You're not even gonna hear me out?
You have a watermelon and a bat. What else could it possibly be? That's more for little kids anyway. Plus, it's really hot out. And look, I get you're trying to be nice.
Yeah, for real. Without you, it would just be me and him, you know? And isn't that just the saddest thing you've ever heard?
Well, when you put it that way, I guess I don't have a choice.
I know, Koromaru. Don't you worry, boy. We didn't forget about you. All right, what are we waiting for? The youngest gets to draw first blood. Now this is what real summer feels like. My blood's pumping something fierce.
Look who's acting like a kid now. Oh yeah, where's the blindfold? We can't split watermelons with just a bat. Speaking of, this bat seems kind of worn in, doesn't it?
Oh wow, you got that. That bat and I go way back. Had it since I was in Little League. I've never mentioned this before. Wow, must have never had a chance to talk about
that I used to play baseball. I mean, anyway, that's old news now.
Wait, then should we really be hitting watermelons with this?
It's cool. Don't think I'll be using it much from here on out. What's wrong, bud? Dying to chomp on some melon? Hey, come on, Koromaru. We can't swing at the watermelon with you in the way.
Koromaru? Hey, why don't we use something other than the bat? Anything, I guess. Just as long as it's interesting.
Interesting? Kind of a weird request. Oh! Like if Sonata-san uses bare hands?
Someone say my name?
Whoa, Sonata-san!
Well, when I got back, I thought I heard voices coming from the roof, so I came to check it out. Watermelon splitting, huh?
That's right! We were just talking about what to use to hit it!
You're not gonna use that bat? My fists. On this?
Oh my god, yes! I'd actually love to see that! That's okay, right, Jufei-san?
Sure. If that's what you want.
Alright. Guess I better make this good then.
Hey, try not to go all out or there won't be any left to eat.
Whoa! Sonata-san, you're incredible!
What? What the heck? How are we supposed to eat it now? Can't believe that thing was still edible after it exploded like that. Didn't go exactly how I was expecting, but looked like a mod-ed. Man, I was acting kind of lame back there, huh? You know, before we busted the melon. I'm talking about the whole bat thing. You were just trying to be thoughtful. I didn't want to come off like I was having second thoughts, but I guess I couldn't help it, huh? I was supposed to be this cool mentor, but instead, the kid ends up pitying me. Don't worry about me anymore. I'll just get even sadder, you know? I mean, I'm not saying it's your fault, dude. How the hell do I put it? This is a me problem. It probably doesn't make sense. I feel like my life, my teenage years, it's just all over the place. Anyway, I think we're done for today, yeah? Appreciate you helping me prep and clean up. Well, let's head back downstairs.
Good evening. I just came by to check in on Koromaru. Do you think he'll do well? That's good to hear. Well, given his reputation for loyalty, I wasn't too worried in the first place. If you have any concerns, please feel free to let me know anytime. It's only fair, considering I was the one who requested that Koromaru join the squad.
Oh, I'm all for Koromaru joining us. He's totally welcome. I'll even throw in training lessons from the master.
I'm pretty sure Koro-chan's already more disciplined than you. Could you even sit still if someone told you to stay?
Hey, don't compare me to a dog. I'm totally disciplined. I can follow directions. Kinda.
yeah, you really sold us on it.
Anyway, so, Mr. Chairman, about those summer classes.
Ah, yes, I heard about Kirijo-kun's plan. It sounded like a good idea, so I went along with it.
No, why would you agree to that?
Oh, was I being nosy?
Oh, I'm missing out on my passionate summer romance. She's disappearing before my eyes. Farewell, my beautiful city girl, awaiting me by the shoreline.
The city or the shores, pick one. Even if you didn't have classes, you'd probably just bum around the station all day. You should just accept your fate. Oh, by the way, Mr. Chairman, weren't you about to tell us something before he arrived?
Hmm? Ah, that's right. Aside from my unnecessary meddling, I do have another request for all of you. Does everyone have a moment? I think it's a good time for you all to get a routine health checkup. You know where Tatsumi Memorial Hospital is, right?
Oh, that's where Sonata-senpai was treated before.
With how much you've all been fighting lately, it'd be best to stay on top of your physical health. It wouldn't be good if your personas were causing any strain on your bodies, right? I expect it shouldn't be too much of a detour to stop by the hospital after your summer classes.
I understand. Still, this is rather sudden.
Don't worry too much about it. Like they say, a stitch in time saves nine. Or your side. We'll be doing the checkups individually, one day at a time. You can decide amongst yourselves who goes when. Don't forget to deck up for your checkup. Just kidding. Oh! Maybe bring your evokers in case you need to take any shots?
Yes.
You see,
into what this old monk has to say? Those folks downstairs, They're probably around your age, huh? It looks like they're having fun drinking and dancing, but you look closely. Their eyes say otherwise. I bet they come here to relieve stress from the day. But I wonder if any of them are actually enjoying themselves. Stress won't go away unless you deal with the root of the issue. You can put it off, and it'll always come back. This place is more of a refuge than a club to me. Those kids really want to relax. We should switch the music to the Heart Sutra. Hey, there's a microphone over there. Bring it over, kid. I'll perform a live sutra reading. Don't underestimate me, kid. My reading of the Heart Sutra will change your life. But I guess you're right. This place is too small to recite it properly. I've got a kid around their age, you know. One and only son. He'll be 21 this year. He's a little older than you. He's alive, that is. It's okay to leave the future of this country in the hands of these kids. I mean, what if they all end up like me? Well, it ain't like I got high hopes for the future. Form is emptiness, emptiness is form. Oh, sorry. I'm done talking now. Go home before it gets too late, all right? I'll see you next time.